Okay, lucky here. So let me start by setting the stage of exactly where I'm at a moment. So I'm sitting in a plane at a cruising altitude of about 36,000 feet at the moment, somewhere in between Seattle and San Francisco, and I'm way home. And I thought, wouldn't it be fun to see if I could use Cubicorn to actually deploy to the digital ocean and get a Kubernetes cluster up and running? Probably about 5 minutes, so let's see. I haven't actually used Cubicorn yet. And for those of you who haven't or heard of Cubicorn or aware of what it does, it's a great open source tool out there developed by a friend and colleague of mine, the wonderful Chris Nova. And friends, I know it's a community effort, so for everybody that's worked on it, fantastic. This is really my first look at it, so if you go to github.com, chris-nova-cubicorn, you can take a look. Now, as of today, you can deploy to AWS and to DigitalOcean. And I thought, let's go ahead and see if we can get something rolled out onto DigitalOcean. So I'm going to follow this walkthrough. I haven't actually done this before, so let's see what happens. And to make this a little more interesting, you can see my DigitalOcean came up here. Let's take a look. And if we take a look at the billing here, I believe I have like a $10 credit. Yeah, I only have $10. So let's see if we get a Kubernetes cluster up and running for less than $10 on Kubernetes, on DigitalOcean at 36,000 feet. Challenge accepted. Let's go. So I've already pulled this down and built the Kubecoin binary. So what I'm going to do now is take this command. Let's have a look. I'm going to create a cluster, and let's just call it DO-cluster01 with the profile DigitalOcean. Okay, so it's created this state file. Let's take a look at that. Okay, so here's the state file. It looks like I have a single master pool and a single node. Okay, so a single master and a single node. And I actually have a specific RSA key for DigitalOcean. That's it, all I'm going to change. So there's my cluster definition, which I believe is a Go struct literal, which is really cool. So now I believe, let's just go back and insert the script here. I actually have a DigitalOcean token. We've done the SSH key. I'm just going to apply that. Okay, so I'm going to say, it says it here. So I've got the state file. Let's go ahead and apply that. Woohoo. Okay, so it's loaded it in. We're going to use my existing key, create a droplet. Okay, so now we should see some action on the DigitalOcean side of things. Cool, so that looks like it's coming up. So, public IPv4 address here. Let's go and actually just SSH to that. SSH minus I, and I'm going to load my RSA DO. I believe the username in the file is root, so let's see if I can get that. Okay, so now I'm trying to log into this node. Okay. Let's see what's happening on this machine. Okay, so it's still in the cloud now. Let's just tail the output of that. Alrighty, so it's pulling a bunch of packages down right now. Cool. Looks like Docker. Stepping through all these packages to obviously get set up, and I think under the hood it's calling kubeatom libraries to bootstrap a cluster. There you go. That looks like a kubeatom cluster create there. Waiting for the API to become ready. Control plane to become ready. Okay, and up here we've created another droplet and updated the state store. So what does that mean? Let's take a look. Oh, okay. Let's put some public key data in here and an item map with the token. Okay. So that has happened. Exit this. Let's just take a look at what's going on. Okay, it looks like all good things control plane wise are coming up here. Let's see the controller manager. So we're probably not too far off from having a cluster by the looks of this. Okay, so it's still on the way up. Cool. And it looks like I probably have a node here as well on the way up. Cool. See if the API server, I assume I can get to it from that post. Oh, okay. So this has actually exited, it wrote a kubeconfig, I now should have a cluster. Let's see if that is indeed true. Kubectl version. So 12.24.58, I kicked this off at 12.22.05, so it'll in 2 to 3 minutes I actually have a cluster. Oh, 172.173 for effort, get nodes. Exit this because it did everything that I hoped it would do. Obviously this isn't slow, I am actually at 36,000 feet going up to a satellite being relayed back down to Earth, going across to a terrestrial link to the SFO2 data center, I believe in DigitalOcean. Yep, SFO2. Okay, so we have a master and a node and they're both in not ready state. Let's go just round out this demo and wait for them to get ready. What other information we have here. A bit more there, and we'll just put a watch on to wait for them to become ready. But how cool is this? I have a Kubernetes cluster in under 3 minutes, bootstrapped, securely bootstrapped using kubeAtom. I believe even the transport, don't quote me on this, is via VPN. Still not ready, so we should eventually get ready here on both those nodes, and I just want to wait to see this out. This is awesome. And then obviously I can delete this once I'm done. Why don't we do this? Kubectl describe nodes. Let's have a look at why it's not ready. Take it probably pieces of the networking stack is still coming up. Okay, kube proxy. We shouldn't be too far off the pods. Yeah, is people having fun in the background here? Okay, yeah, we're still waiting for container creating and calibrate to come up. So this is why we're not in ready state. We're waiting for networking to come up, which is fine. Probably have one in ready by the looks of it, because we have one Calico node running, one kube proxy running. So, okay, so with the master's ready, and then once Calico is running on the node 0, we should go to ready because networking will be up. But how awesome is this? Very excited for the future of this project and being able to utilize great tools like this that are open source to bootstrap clusters. Okay, so once all those are pulled, we can rest assured that it's going to go to state up and running. Let's see if anything is running on that other node yet. So once Calico node this goes up and running, so we'll have a look at the state of that. describe pod boom. This is just extra now. We have a cluster up and running, and once all these things finish, we should be good. Okay, yeah, it's still pulling the image as of 54 seconds ago. It's now pulling the CNI plugin package from Calico 191. I'm going to go ahead and round out this video and just say, very excited for this tool. Thanks for joining, and this has been a lot of fun. Cheers.